Number three. Number three. In terms of giving to the Lord first, ang sabi nyo sa Luke 6:38, okay, I'm gonna prove this thing to you, that sometimes we have to give to the Lord first because God has given His part already. In Luke 6:38, ang sabi ni Lord, give and it will be given to you a good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, will be poured into your lap. Sa tubig. Amen? For with the measure, look at this. Look at this. I like this one. For the measure you use, it will be measured to you. Amen? Mga kapatid, every time you sacrifice something for God, God is going to repay you more than what you expect. Sabi nga, you cannot outgive God. Amen po ba? If you offer something to the Lord with the sacrifices, with tears in your eyes, you're doing the things of God, you sacrifice the thing you value most, you sacrifice the person you love most. Mga kapatid, when God tries to pay you back, I'm telling you this, it's going to be beyond description. I'm saying this not to make you feel good. I'm not that kind of preacher. But whenever I speak the promises of God, I'm telling you this. That is the promise of God for you. Hindi mo po pwedeng paigil si Lord sa pagbibigay. Pag nagbigay ka ng sakripisyo, nagbigay ka ng pagtitiwala, God's gonna bless you more than you could ever imagine. Amen po ba? Alam ako, during the time when we're having a ministry back in the Philippines, the God is alive people now in our church. We are bringing wooden, what do you call that? Wooden bench? Mga kasama ko, mga babae. Dalawa kami na lakas, yung mga babae. Alam niyo mga buhat namin? Isang babae, dalawang sila yung wooden chair. Ganyan kahaba. Ipapatukan yung gagawin kami. Outreach kami. Alam niyo kung saan kami dumadaan? Hindi na ba tawag doon? Pitak ba yun? Sa Pilapin! Kung naalala ko, sabi ko, napaka-recognize namin. Sa Mindanao kami nagpupunta, natinig nila sa Mindanao. So, you are not allowed to wear high heels. Flats is binisan, ano lang, sleepers lang. But you know what? That is the time that God has blessed us. Both spiritually and practically. Bakit? Because we have given much. Because God has given much already. It is your turn to give some of the Lord. Amen? Lastly, number three, God shall release His power when we relate to Him in an intimate way as to who He is and what He can do. Without a personal, intimate relationship with God, mga kapatid, there's no way that God can display His power at you. Amen? Unless God has a special favor on you, amen? Unless God has special favor on you, na wala kang relasyon sa Kanya, ay binilas ka. There's only one instance in the Bible that God has blessed yung crippled. Naalala niyo? During the time when God has healed the crippled boy, at ang sabi ng the disciples said, Lord, this crippled boy, do you think we have sinned, the mother or the father? And then the son of Jesus Christ, no. Neither one of them has sinned against me. He was born that way so that the grace and the mercy and the power of God will be displayed. Amen? Alam mo, in one way or another, people, disciples, you are crippled. You are lame. You are deaf. You are mute. That's because God designed you to be that way, but simply because God wants to display His power of you. Amen ba? But only this thing can happen, ang sabi po rito, only this thing will happen if you are intimately connected to Him. Sabi natin, intimately connected to Him. How are you going to be connected to the Lord? Prayer? Devotion? Going to the church? Fellowship? Amen? Pag nagkalat na si Lord ng blessing, nandun ka, kasama ka. Why? Because you're always present. I'm not saying you're always present in the church, but you're always present communing to the Lord, praising Him in your own private time. Sabi po rito, because that is the time, because we relate to Him in intimate ways. Hindi pwedeng copy-paste. Kung ano rin, kung ano na rin ang pagkakakilala ng iba, makikigaya ka na rin. We need to know Him in accordance the way He revealed Himself to us in a personal way. Ano ba? Hindi po pwedeng copy-paste. Kaya nga sabi rito, sa Matthew 6:13-19, I'm going to tell you this. Matthew 16:13-19, and I would like to end up on this one. When Jesus came to the region of Caesarea Philippi, He asked His disciples, "Who do people say the Son of Man is?" And then they replied, "Some say you are John the Baptist. Others say you are Elijah. And still others, Jeremiah or one of the prophets." Tinatanong ni Lord, yung mga disciples, sabi niya, ano ba sabi ng mga tao sa akin, sino ba ako? Ay, following you. Ang sabi ng isa, ay ang sabi niya, ikaw daw si Moses. Ang sabi ng isa, ikaw daw si John the Baptist. Ang sabi ng iba, ikaw ay si Jeremiah o isa sa mga propeta. Pero, in return, God replied, ang sabi ni Lord, "But what about you?" He asked. "Who do you say I am? Who do you say I am?" Maganda yung sagot. And then Simon Peter answered, "You are the Son of the living God." And then Jesus replied, "Blessed are you, Simon, son of Jonah. For this was not revealed to you by flesh and by blood, but by my Father in heaven." And because of personal revelations of God in the life of Simon Peter, here is the promise. As sabi ni Lord, after He's been revealed to Peter, "And I tell you that you, Peter, on this rock, I will build my church, and the gates of Hades will not overcome it. I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven. Whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth will be loose in heaven." Do you know the promise of God when God revealed Himself to Simon Peter? Amen? Ang sabi niya, "You, Simon, on this rock." Ano ba natin ang pag-aralan natin? Ang talagang pangalan, ang ibig sabihin ng pangalan ng Peter, alam mo ano? Pebbles. Ano yung pebbles? Pebbles, whatever you call it. Yung maliit. Pero no, nakilala na si Lord, you know what? From small thing, from something that people doesn't know, ang sabi nito, "On this rock." Ko kayo naginirap. You know what? What's the reason? Because of His personal revelation. Because of His personal knowledge about who God is. Mga kapatid, you must know what God can do. You must know who God is. You must know the characteristics of God. Because it depends on how God will perform miracles sa buhay mo. If you don't know that God is a healing God, there's no way that there will be a healing miracles in your life. If you don't know that God is the one who provides His Jehovah Jireh, there's no way that God can give a financial breakthrough, miracles in your life. Amen? I'm going to answer this question before I end up. What do you know about God? If God is going to ask you this question, who do you say I am? Alam mo kung bakit mahalaga? Your answer to this question will depend how God is going to perform miracles in your life. Who do you say I am? ang tingin mo kay Lord niya? Kung ang tingin mo kay Lord isang maliit na Diyos, if you think that God is not a miracle working God, you cannot experience it. It is miracles. Amen ba? But God is a miracle working God. Ang sabi ng word ng Panginoon, as I follow on brother again, there's nothing that God cannot do. In the most favorite verses of all time, I can do all things through Christ who is strengthening me. The God I know is the same God who raised Lazarus from the grave. Amen? The same God that I know is the same God who fed the 5,000 out of 2 pieces of loaves and fish. The same God that I know is the same God who divided the sea and there was no way to escape from the enemy. The same God I know is the same God who created the heaven and the universe. The same God I know is the same God who offered his best for me. Now, kapatid, who do you say God is? Ano ba kailangan natin? A reserve fire? Na kapag wala ka lang mapupuntahan, sila lang mapupuntahan mo, no? He must be everything and he must be the only thing and the only person in your life. Amen? Let's all stand up. Hallelujah. Praise you all. Praise you, Lord. Hallelujah. Praise you, God. We have to realize our dependence in Him with desperation. And we must have to release something right now. If you would like to have a miracle before God, mga kapatid, throw to the ground whatever you're going to have in your hands right now. Whatever the depression is. Because God would like to display His power and miracles in your life. And then lastly, God would like you to relate to Him very personally. Amen? As I pray, I would like to pray for all of you, and I would like everyone to please bow down. Anyone here whom you think you are needing a great miracle from God, maybe not really a great miracle, but you need something that is beyond explanation, that seems impossible, right? You know, God is inviting you. God is inviting you right now. We would like to perform miracles in your life. All you have to do is to ask this in great desperation and say, Lord, there's nothing more left. You're the only one left for God. And I would like to trust you right now in the things that I have in front of me. As everybody's eyes are closed, I would like to pray for you. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. The Spirit of the Living God, Lord, fill this place with the wonderful presence of God. Lord, there's nothing I can do. Lord, if you are not with us, if your presence, if your Holy Spirit of God is not with us this afternoon, Lord, I can only talk, I can only speak, but I cannot change everything. But even the small things, oh God, there's nothing I can change. But Lord, in your presence, oh God, Lord, fill this room, fill this hall, oh God, with your presence, with your Holy Spirit. I know, Lord, that in heaven, Lord, in the spiritual realm, oh God, Lord, something is happening. Lord, in the lives and in the heart of this person right now, crying out with desperation, believing, oh God, that Lord, before you, there's nothing impossible. Probably, Father God, for the eyes of man, before the eyes of man, everything is so hard and so difficult. But Lord, you have said in your word, before you, there's nothing so difficult for me. And Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus, I'm praying, oh God, Lord, the move of your Holy Spirit right now. Amen. Lord, and even Lord, the miracles we need, so that we could change the things that we cannot change. Lord, and even in our weaknesses, oh God, that you're gonna give us strength and power and victory. For those people, Father God, having difficulty, Lord God, Lord, battling it out with our sins because of our sinful natures. Lord, we need miracles. We need your power, oh God. We need your power, Lord. Even Lord, for the lives of those people that we love, but they don't know Christ yet. They don't know you yet, oh God. And Lord, sometimes we're losing hope. In the mighty name of Jesus, there is still a miracle that cry out to the Lord with great desperation, with the greatest grace of God, and we're saying, Lord, you are all we need, oh God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Lord, we are praying for our husbands, for our wives, who don't have a personal relationship with you yet. Lord, I believe and I know it may seem so difficult, but the God we are serving is a miracle working God. Nothing is so important with you, God. Lord, we thank you, God. Right now, coming on, we believe without any doubt in our hearts that you can answer all these prayers that we have, because we know that you are the living God, that you are the miracle working God. We thank you, Lord. We would like to give you all the praises and all the thanksgiving. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Let's give the Lord a big hand. Praise the Lord. You may all be seated for our communion. Hallelujah.